What is a po'boy? You need another question.
What is a po'boy? Well, I don't know, bread.
I'm saying it's the messiness and what's inside, yeah.
The deliciousness.
Really good bread. Really good fried seafood.
The bread was good, and the fried oysters are crispy and tender.
I put the bread at the bottom of what's important about it.
Everyone knows what a po'boy is.
Thank you, Melvin. Oh, you enjoy.
Someone that doesn't have a lot of money.
Can I grab this? It's a po'boy loaf, right? So without this, you don't have a po'boy. You got a sub, you got a hoagie, you got whatever else they want to call it, but without this, you don't have a po'boy. It's all about the crunch. We're gonna fill it full of mayo, lettuce, tomatoes, pickles, and some kind of protein of some sort. So you need a crispy outside, but you need a soft inside.
Po'boy is just culture you can eat here in New Orleans. It's something that every walk of life has. 8 to 80, young, old. New York has a hero. Philadelphia has the Philly cheesesteak. The po'boy is New Orleans' big city sandwich, and it started during a time that was troublesome. And that was the height of the Great Depression. It was 1929.
There was a sandwich shop owned by the Martin brothers, and there was a streetcar strike.
When the hard times hit, a lot of people weren't getting paid, especially the New Orleans streetcar workers, but they still wanted them to work, so they striked.
So I started making them gravy sandwiches with french fried potatoes.
French bread at that time was shaped like a football. It was big in the middle and skinny on the ends. So an Italian baker came up with a consistent loaf from beginning to end. And it's actually called the Poorboy loaf.
So the way that name, Poorboy, came, the workers would see the customers coming and they would say, there is another Poorboy coming.
That's the Poorboy you see today. And look what it turned into.
My husband's grandfather lived across the street from where we are now. And he bought this property and started a bar. It's the same bar we have outside now. It's over 100 years old. And one of the things when we were renovating in the plan was, I want customers to walk in that front door and not have any idea that it was renovated. It needs to look exactly the same. And there's a ring toward the bottom of the chairs, how many feet had to be placed on there for that metal to be totally worn off. You see the path where people have walked over the years. It's going back in time, and it's truly a mom and pop operation. There's no doubt about that. I mean, this is mom. I have a couple of people who work here. Raymond's been here for 53 years, 45 of those as a bartender. So most people, when they walk in the doors, if they haven't been here in 20, 30 years, they know Ray the bartender. They'll ask me for him. Going back in time really is.
Everything's the same. Now we have a back kitchen. We cook our own roast beef and we save the drippings and we make a homemade gravy.
We're traditional. If you look at our menu board, you know, it's the roast beef and the fried shrimp, fried oysters, fried catfish. When the customer places their order,
small roast beef and Swiss,
they tell you how they want it dressed. That is made specifically for that person.
I think I've died and gone to heaven.
The recipes have basically stayed the same, basically. Forever, really.
All right, people out there, this is where I want you to look on your monitor, your screen, your computer, whatever. Press that nose icon and open up your smell-o-vision. Oh, that smells so good. Oh, you're not gonna get me on some braggadocious rant that I'm the best. You will start a fight in any neighborhood you go in with that question. Everybody wants to say their place is the best. But I can say this, I probably have made more po'boys than anybody else. Maybe in the history of this stuff. I've literally made a million po' boys, over a million po' boys, myself personally.
It's actually my first time having a po' boy. I'm pretty excited. I heard from a few different people that this is one of the best places to get them, so I had to come here and try them.
When I make a sandwich, it's gotta be balanced, earthy. I like three tomatoes, pickle in the middle of each tomato. So I have all the power in my hands to make that the product I want to make. All over the world, they've written about my shrimp sandwich. This is what the part people don't believe, is that I don't need to look at those shrimp. I'm listening to them. So many times, going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So finally, I'm getting a little older, a little wiser, and I just listen. And as the water cooks out of them, you hear less psh. I'm listening for that right note, you know? Like when Pavarotti hits it. Boom! And you're like, oh, that's Pavarotti. I love my job. I do. I really do.
I remember the stories when I was a little boy, not knowing what this place was. Parkway, I say it's the oldest po' boy shop in business. You know, we were around before the po' boy, but we didn't invent it. We just saw a trend, a family that had it. The Timothy family saw a good something going on, and they jumped on board with it. And let me tell you, this family, the Timothy family, they had it from the 20s all the way until 1995. Two brothers, a mama, a sister. They ran this place, and you better know what you want. Those guys, I never met them, but they were tough. That's what kind of area it was back then. Blue collar, working class. You come in, you know, what do you want? New Orleans likes to stay true to their roots. They don't like change. So you had to reopen this place as Parkway Bakery, and that's what we did. It's a real old school joint, but we like to do fun things too. So we got an alligator sausage sandwich that's really different, you know, really spicy and flavorful. Homemade sausage made right here in the neighborhood. We got one that won first place at the Po' Boy Fest. I said, look, let's turn this roast beef, let's make it a barbecue beef. Let's fry the shrimp, let's put some hot sauce mayo on it, throw some pepper jack cheese on that, and we blow torch that down, melt it down real nice. And dress it lettuce, tomato, pickle. I mean, it's one of the best sandwiches you ever have. You can't argue with delicious, and that's what we do here.
I have a saying that I use with my workers. I always tell them, everything you do, do like you would do for the person you love the most in the world. And if you do that, everything you do is going to be perfect.
You go to a fancy highfalutin restaurant, white tablecloth. New Orleans has some of the best in the country. But mostly, you know, you're only gonna get people who can afford that kind of stuff. I'm not knocking it, it's just the way it is. Po' Boy Shop brings them all together for whatever reason. If it's just, it has that rite of passage that makes everybody feel comfortable because it's been entrenched in the city for so long. It's something for everybody.